Men. Ui, na, du, du,
Estamos en un pueblo de gente local, muy simpática, nos han aceptado muy bien y estoy muy contento de volver a estar con gente de puta madre.
Men.
Uy, na, lu, lu,
Hola, buenas tardes, señores y señores pasajeros. Hello, this is Mark Bicker, and this is a crazy trip about Jose Porquerajeta and me on Pacific Coast 2009. I was there 4 months, Porquerajeta was within 1 month or something like that. Whatever. This is no GoPro bullshit camera.
My name is Matti Bicker, and I'm a spear fisher from Finland. And this is a story of my crazy trip in Pacific area. I'm trying to get the fish. I try to be like the fish. So this is the images you will get, and later on you will understand what's happening here. But this is just to let you know what kind of guy I am. Hey, hey, hey. Okay. by PNG Papua New Guinea style. I found a place which is the Virgin. I'm the first white man fishing here, spearfishing. And why there is a lot of fish, big tunas, everything, is because there is no Chinese, Philippines or Taiwanese fishing boats. Because all the Solomon Islands, you know, there was these boats all many places, and so all the fishes are gone. So this is the place, it's the virgin place, still fish left, and you have to fight.
You
kick their ass, you know. You see the Philippine boat, you go there and do the PNG style cannibal, you know, eat. You eat all those guys because they're very bad, they're taking all the fish. So this is the best place.
Yeah.
You will see some great stuff here. Hey!
What can I get? I didn't understand.
Papua New Guinea prison. How is it? Holiday or difficult?
Oh, it's a holiday camp. You go there. You holiday. You just relax. Yeah, right? It's a holiday camp.
Okay. Can we sing together?
Now, GPS DR bros bought to Wagina last night. They're going to pick up a sick person. It's a soldier with a big engine.
You have to pick up?
No, they're open.
Eh?
Yeah, 2 o'clock in the morning.
They go?
Yeah.
And we go without GPS?
No. You know, very. You go 2 hours, 45 minutes. Decide.
And he know well?
Yeah.
Find it? Yeah?
He know everything. I stay with. We're fishing with this boy at about 10 years. Stay with me.
Yeah. My name is Joseba. So he arrived to the buoy?
Yeah.
No problem?
No problem. You know everything.
All the buoys or only one buoy?
No, you go to the first one because there are two There are two buoys there. Person about to finish take it last week. Last yesterday, the other one come. The other fisherman tell me.
Ah, fishing there already?
Yeah. We cannot go there. Spend the time. Go this side. You know what I'm telling you. Mm-hmm. Go to number one. The first. When you come back and you check up the first island, you know. Kingfish and barracuda.
Yeah. But first we go to the
yeah.
And this kind of place, still nobody was fishing there.
Now you want just to try. If the tuna come, you're going to stay there. Mm-hmm. You come refill him this one, Corey.
Tell me, how many liters do you think they are here?
How much liter you got it last night?
40.
40 liters, that's 20, 20.
You think it's 20 liters, all right?
Yeah.
Okay, like this. Hello, hello, good morning, yeah. 5:45 here at the reef. Totally dark. Still waiting for a little bit of sun to come up. This is the best time, but now I have to really be taking easy because plenty sharks can be here now. Oof.
Yes, we are always looking for the stream. It's all about the current. It's all about that. That is the reason why we go with these village people, we go to remote islands, the faraway places, because there, the authentic current, it's the islands, the corals, the reefs, and we are there, in front of the stream, all the little fish, plankton, everything is messed up there. That's why the visibility is not so good, that's why the BBC is not there, because they want the clear water, they want to see the, you know, the bah, that's nothing, clear water sucks. When there's a lot of plankton, all kind of action, little fish, we go there and the big fish is coming. Then you wait and you're part of the system, you're a fish, and the predators are coming, and you're just sneaking there and do your best. Oof, the Philippines, Taiwanese, they have messed up the everything. You have to go so far, so far. You have to go 20, 30 meters, waiting for there. The fish is coming, you go up against the sunlight and you hit it. You hit it, man.
Anna olla kuule viimeinen kerta, menet sinne kouluun nyt. Et sä voi aina tolla tavalla myöhästyä. Sit kun sä asut omassa kodissas, sit sulla on aivan omat säännöt. Niin kauan kun sä asut tässä huushollissa, toimitaan tämän talon säännöillä. Sit kun sulla on oma talo, tee ihan kuule mitä huvittaa. Nyt ylös siitä. Hello.
Yo.
What is the name of the island? Village?
Timonai.
What?
Timonai Village.
Hey, Timonai Village here.
Rumble! 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 Thank you. 10 euros.
50 de ice. Enfoca el ice. Thank you. Mira qué market, tío, quieres, joder.
No, pescado podrido.
I would prefer what do I say? I can't think of anything, but yeah, for now I can't think of anything, but there are quite a lot of things to be changed.
We're going to Roba Island.
Roba Island.
Yeah.
Okay, it's far.
Roba Island.
Roba, it's like 2 hours with the boat from Lorengau. We go to this.
Not two, no, hours, 30 minutes.
No, it's more.
No, 1 hour, only one hour. Yeah, only 1 hour. 1 hour.
What is the difference that make? Doesn't make any difference. Anyway, we go in there, and we try to find the current because now there was no current in the coastline. So we try to find these little islands where the current is hitting. So I think there is a big fish there, and also there is not so many fishermen because I saw that here many people fishing. People fish scared, you know.
Yeah, that's very true.
It's good
because this one is every.
Is it good?
It's a big
yeah, so we're gonna get the big fish, and then we're gonna have an icy, we put the ice, then we're gonna smoke the fish, we're gonna sell the fish, and we're gonna buy a lot of beers, no?
Yeah, of course, something like that.
But tomorrow we have to wake up 4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, around 4 o'clock, and then we can depart from here around...
Five. We go.
So maybe we'll do like this. Boat will travel from here to Lonely Bridge. We just hop on the car from here to the bridge, and we open the boat at the bridge and go.
Ah, that we are in the marina,
yeah.
You think it's a good idea?
Yeah, it's a good idea because the boat will fast.
Yes, that's very good idea. But can we leave the boat, car there?
No, the car, the driver will take the car back. We're gonna pick one driver, and the driver will drop off.
Okay, that's a good idea, but you have to organize that.
Yeah, it's already done.
Still a papoose. Thank you. So today we were fishing because of super current. We put the floater where is the reef, and then we went against the reef with the boat. And then I was diving like 200 meters before the reef, and I went down to 20-25 meters, and the big Dr. Tuna was there. So I was able to shoot some, but no filming. Too difficult to take the camera there.
East Gate, Papua New Guinea, you can see from the map, best place. A lot of stream, a lot of stuff. Not so good visibility, but great people.
Kene?
Hey, Basque.
Why we didn't get the big fish today? Only little fish?
Because this place don't have big fish. People are fishing with dynamite. And no good place.
Dynamite? Dynamite fishing?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
But how they can put dynamite? It's wet, it's cold, it doesn't explode.
No, they get dynamite for the Second World War bombs. Then people there have they're available dynamite anywhere. For that, this is a problem. People don't have culture, use the dynamite, and kill every fish. Some places have still fish, but difficult to find big fish in Guadalcanal. We have to go to other island to search something better.
It's okay, crying.
Huh? You know I'm going to take you to court
here
because of filming me without any, you know. You have to ask me, okay?
I'm sorry.
Stop that bloody fucking camera now.
Yeah, not only East Cape, all Alotau open electric. I mean, Alotau.
But you have a owner candidate in East Cape.
Yes, okay. We got two.
Ah. But you don't think Henry is the best candidate?
Yeah, he's best. Everything is best. In a picture, you can see him. He's best and his platform's here. But I got a man from East Cape. I'll vote him.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah.
I have right to vote to East Cape man. Eh? A man from East Cape.
It's basically when the word corruption come in, it's basically in the mind of the people, in the way that people think about corruptions, because many times people always think that they use the government as a source of money. A politician gives something to them and that's what they expect. But usually the politicians are there to support the common social programs that belongs to people, which means that the government provide a classroom, provide the schools, provide a hospital, provide a roads. Whereas people expect that a member is supposed to give them money and to feed them on, and when the government doesn't provide that, that is where they interpret that there is mismanagement of funds from the members of parliament. But really, it is the system that leaders must give money for major services that the nation require.
You have to do so much work, so much travel, so much experience to find these special spots where you can see fish like this. This Pacific Ocean is definitely the empty ocean. There is so much places where there is no fish, nothing. Even the local guys, they can't find the fish. We have to work together many days and then we find these places where there's fish like this. It's unbelievable, this. The Western people, you know, I don't know, the sushi eating guys, you know, eat the stone. If you eat the fish, go there and pick up yourself. Fucking mate.
north of New Hanover Island. It's pretty tough here, 3-4 days raining, no boats going, big waves, hardcore waves, and I have my feet are infected. I have to eat some antibiotics. Local doctors, the bush doctors, oof, hardcore. So let's hope that finally we will get the, we will get to the place where we find the big fish and a lot of good visibility. So let's see, can we do it?
Hey, what's happening here? Papua New Guinea. I hope you like everything. The best country in Papua. So see you later.
Yep.
You have a girlfriend?
Yes.
Hey, you sit down.
Hey, sit down. Hey.
Where are you now? Where are you?
Sit down there.
Hey, sit down.
What's your name?
Nalo.
Nalo, okay. What are you gonna do? You gonna stay always in the village or you want to move to the town?
Move to the town.
Ah, you like town life?
No.
O'clock in the morning, and this is the last morning in Lavangai. We are going very, very early to the reef. So let's keep fingers that everything going to be right, because I really want to go home in one piece. I really want to go home.
The living legend. There is no other. There is no other human who has been experienced so much life underwater, underground. He is the man. He's the Jack Kusner number 7. Why he is not in the United Nations? He could be the missing link who would help how we can save these oceans. Of course, you need the university, but we need some guys like him, who has the experience. He knows so much. And what is the Spanish kid doing? He's nothing, he's just fighting. It's unbelievable. If he would be a French guy, he would be a José Baguera head of society. Hanging around, everything, wannabes, but nothing. He's just doing his own stuff. He's an artist, he's an amazing person. That's, I don't know, it's a little bit sad, somehow stupid. Good luck, man. Good luck, the ocean.
Iya, iya, tuh ini dulu.
Kaksikymmentä neljä. Sitten kerran. Ja pyydettiin. Sitten